One of my personal favorite sporting events that I look forward to every year is Penn State University's annual whiteout game. I love this game more for the atmosphere than the game itself. I've never attended the game in person, but to see over 100,000 fans dressed in all white supporting their team is just awesome. You don't need to be a football fan to be in awe of this truly amazing event. And this got me thinking, color, whether used in a sporting event or in marketing, instantly sets a mood. It evokes an emotion and even triggers a psychological reaction. So when you set up your emails, do you ever think about the colors you use and how it may impact your reader's behavior? There are so many different ways you could use colors in your emails, from the background to the call to action to the links to the images. And the cumulative effect of those colors says something about you and your content. So how are you using color? Do you use the email template default colors? Do you pick your favorite colors? Or you just stick with your brand colors? If you're not thinking about the colors you use in your emails, it's time. Why? Because 85% of consumers surveyed believe color is important when buying a product. And color increases brand recognition by 80%. That makes it an incredibly important part of your brand identity. Let's take a look at some examples. Here's an example from Canva where they use a purple call to action. Now, why are they using purple? Purple is known to encourage creativity. And for those of you who know the brand Canva, it's a graphic design tool. So it's possible they strategically chose the color purple for their branding and also for the CTA within their newsletters to inspire creativity with their audience. Here's another example from the published press. A lot of newsletters you receive will typically use the shade of blue when linking to text. And this is the default color for text-based links. But the published press switches up by using red. This is a good choice as red psychologically promotes an action. And the goal of the published press is to get people to click on their links to consume more content. Here's another example I absolutely love. This is an email from Harry's, and they use an all black background. And the back background is meant to position the product as a classic, sophisticated look, which I think they did a tremendous job. Very simple email, but I think it definitely portrays the emotion they were trying to evoke with this is color palette. So how do you know what color you should be using in your email? Well, to start, let's look at the meaning of the various colors that you could choose. So red could be used to promote an action. It's an energy color. It creates excitement. Orange is warmth. It's youthful, portrays bravery. Yellow, another youthful color, happiness, cheerful. Green is more associated with nature and natural, health and well-being, newness, freshness, quality. Blue is a luxurious classic color, portrays peace and loyalty. Pink portrays compassion, sincerity, sophistication. Purple is an elegant, royal, luxurious color. Brown, dependable, rugged, trustworthy. Black, classic, conventional, sophisticated. And white is clean, calm, simple, honest, the innocence of the color white. So now that you know the different color meanings, let's see different ways that you could potentially use them in your email. When you want your audience to take a specific action like buying a product or downloading a guide or reading your blog post, the best colors to use could be red and yellow because they promote an action. They grab attention. Yellow, for example, is also associated with happiness, self-esteem, creativity. From a marketing standpoint, red and yellow are your most action-oriented colors. But that doesn't mean other colors won't work. Take the Canva example that I shared with you earlier. They use purple as the call to action. At AWeber, we typically use blue as the call to action. Now, these are our branding colors, which is perfectly fine to use for your call to action. My recommendation for you would be, you know, test, see what colors work best for you as your call to actions. You could also change up the backgrounds of your emails. Draw attention to certain products or causes or events by switching up the background color within certain sections of your email. So a few examples would be, you could use a green background to represent something that's fresh or new. So this could be great when promoting a new product, or if you're a wellness coach and you want to promote a service, or you're just showcasing an environmentally friendly product or service, green would be great to use in these situations. Purple is uplifting and calm. It symbolizes luxury. So you could use this when you're positioning your product or brand as prestigious, or you want to inspire creativity with your audience. Another example could be a blue background, which represents trust and success. And you could use this when promoting an educational webinar or podcast because you want the end result of them attending your podcast or listening or attending your webinar or listening to your podcast as, you know, as success. They've achieved something after, you know, listening to your content. Another example might be a tip that you want to call out in your newsletter. Now, the colors you use in your marketing emails should be chosen based on the purpose of the email. So, for example, an email newsletter. These types of emails are typically used to send your subscribers regular updates with news, information, or educational content. So you want to use a lot of white space in these emails with a splash of your brand colors. The idea is to get your subscribers to read the content, so you don't want secondary colors drawing their attention away. The only exception to this principle is if you want your newsletter readers to click on a link in the newsletter, say to read a blog article or watch a video. In that case, use a call to action button that will draw their attention and make the click. And as we discussed earlier, you potentially want to test a red or a yellow call to action button. Welcome emails. This email is usually one of the first interactions a customer will have with your brand. So use your brand colors to reinforce your company's visual identity. Sales emails. The colors you use in your sales emails will vary depending on your offer. So the colors you use in email to influence your audience's behavior is just one of the many ways that the psychology of color in your overall marketing efforts can be applied. These principles can also be used on your website, landing pages, sign-up forms, social media, and more. But what I encourage you to do first is to test various elements within your email. If you have a theory or an idea of how color might be used to influence your audience's behavior, I encourage you to test it out.